Hello, welcome back. In this video, we will see how we can use the features that we have extracted before to train a classification model. So we will use this model to detect different fault conditions in our Flowpak machine. So we will use the model to see whether we have failures on the electrical side, or maybe on the mechanical side of the plant, or maybe both. So let's see how we can do this in MATLAB and how we can use these features. So to do this, we will open a different live script. So let's go here and let's make this a bit bigger. Okay, so the first thing that we do now is loading the table that we have built before. And you will recognize the same table that we had before. So we have a few features here. We have a large number of columns, each column for each feature. And then we also have a fault code column. So we use this column to describe the six different fault conditions that we can have in our Flowpak machine. So we can have mechanical failures, we can have electrical failures, we can have a combination of both with different levels of severity. So let's go now and let's normalize the data. So once the data is normalized, we still have to deal with a large number of features. So in particular, we have more than 30 features. So what we want to do now is actually reduce the number of features that we will work with. And this is very useful if we need to finally deploy the algorithm on an embedded processor. We want to make sure that the model is not too big. So what we do here, we evaluate the correlation matrix. And then we can take a look at how the features are correlated to each other. So with one, we plot features which are correlated and the correlation is higher than 80%. So thanks to this information, we just remove some features. And then after we remove features, we want to see which ones of these features that are left actually do a good job at separating the six different fault conditions that we have simulated in the Flowpak machine. So to do this, we will use the NCA, so the neighbor component analysis. And this analysis will give us a weight for each feature. And the weight essentially represents how well the feature can separate the different classes. So in this plot, you can see on the x-axis the feature index, and then on the y-axis the weight. So in summary, the higher the weight, the better the feature. So we need to select features which allows us to separate the six different fault conditions well. And to do this, for example, we can choose to select only the features that have a weight higher than one. And this basically means that we are still and further reducing the number of features that we will work with. And we collect this in a table. And the table is called feature data training. And as you can see, this feature data training has only 10 columns. So now we can use this table to train a machine learning model. So we use the classification learner app. And from this app, what we can do, we can import the table that contains both the predictors, which are the features, and the label, which is the class that we need to distinguish. So we get this table here. We can see that we have more than 2000 rows, which is the number of simulations, but only 10 columns. And then we can here choose how we want to validate our model. So in this case, we choose to keep 80% of the data for training and 20% for validation. Okay, so now from the classification learner app, you can see how the features that we have extracted before actually do a good job at clustering and separating different classes. So the classes that we have are represented here with different colors. And here, just by switching the predictor, you can see how this affects the clustering. So here the aim is actually really to just quickly see if you can individuate any possible combination of features that will actually separate the classes well. And for example, here with these two features, we seem to have a good separation between the classes. And you know, thanks to this information, you can further reduce the number of features that you will use for training. So for example, in this case, we decide to keep the variance of the position error, and then the maximum value of the current and the kurtosis for the speed of the motor. So we could also do PCA, principal component analysis, but we will skip this for now. Okay, so from here, we have a large number of models that we can use for training. Here really, you know, you can either choose one of these models if you have knowledge of your system, or if you have already a hint on which one could be good, or maybe, you know, you could just go on and train all the models. And, you know, with the parallel computing option enabled, you can train multiple models at the same time. And here you can see that you have an accuracy result, which basically is telling us how well the algorithm is distinguishing the different faults. So now we can stop some of this and we can take a look at the SVM. So the SVM in this case has an accuracy of around 93%. But you know, let's see what this means exactly. So we can take a look at the confusion matrix. And the confusion matrix is a good measure of understanding how well or badly our algorithm is performing. So with this confusion matrix, what we see is predicted classes on the x-axis, and then the true classes on the y-axis. A good model will have high values on the main diagonal and then low values on the off diagonal elements. But you know, for example, here we see a 23%. So this basically means that when the true class was gearbox warning, we were actually saying that the class was okay. And only 75% of the times we are predicting this in a correct way. So, you know, maybe we want to try and fix this. So we can use the misclassification costs from the classification learner app. And, you know, what we can do from here, we can penalize some of these errors. Okay, so once we do this, we can retrain the model. But it's very important to keep in mind that all we're doing here is just shifting and distributing the errors in the matrix. And indeed, what you see here is that now we have an error in a different situation. When the class was okay, we were actually predicting it as a gearbox warning 72% of the times. And maybe that's okay, because here now we're being a bit more conservative. So this is just to say that you can use the misclassification costs to optimize the way that your algorithm works, but you can further optimize your algorithm by performing hyperparameter optimization. So for instance, you can choose an optimizable SVM model, and then you can select a few options. So for example, here you can decide what parameters you want to optimize and which ones you want to keep fixed. And then you can also choose the optimizer options. So if you want to use a Bayesian optimization, a grid search, a random search, and so on. And then you can also specify the training time limits. So for example, in this case, I'm setting the time for optimization to 60 seconds. Okay, so once we set this, we can carry on training. And what we're doing now, we are actually watching how the optimization goes on. And this is a very powerful way to perform hyperparameter optimization, because it can be done directly from the classification learner app without writing any MATLAB code. So once we're done, we can see how the algorithm has improved. So now we have an accuracy of 89% compared to 84% in the previous case. And then in particular, we can take a look at the confusion matrix. So as you can see now, the error has decreased to 52% compared to 72% in the previous case. And also you can see that the classification accuracy for the gearbox warning is still pretty high. Okay, so at this point, we just need to use this model that we have trained in the Classification Learner app. And we have a couple of ways to do so. So the first way is to export the model in the MATLAB workspace. So we can give it a name and click OK. Or maybe we can actually generate a MATLAB function directly from the app. And this contains all the necessary lines of code to replicate what we did interactively. And this is very useful if we want to automate the process next time. So now let's take a look at the model that we have exported. And this is what we will use in the next video to first test our classification on the desktop. And then we will see how we can generate code from this and deploy it on a PLC. So if you want to have more details, stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.